Hi, it's Michelle from Lab Muffin Beauty Science, chemistry PhD and acne-prone skin owner. At the end of July this year, I went to Jakarta, Indonesia to participate in Jakarta X Beauty. Thank you so much to Female Daily Network who run this event for sponsoring me and collaborating on this video. Jakarta X Beauty is a 3-day event in central Jakarta that brings together brands, beauty content creators, and beauty lovers. The event was spread across 3 venues with 120 brands participating. There's lots of shopping deals and promotions. There's also loads of interesting talks with over 80 speakers participating this year. I did 2 talks. One was on hyperpigmentation with Kay. We talked about the difference between brightening and whitening and how to safely even out your skin tone. I also did a talk about acne with Dr. Irini. We talked about different types of acne, what contributes to acne, and how to treat different types of acne as well. One of the things we talked about was how to squeeze a pimple properly. Or by properly, we mean with the least amount of damage. Because officially, you shouldn't squeeze your pimples. You should go to a dermatologist who can do it properly with the least amount of risk, because if you don't squeeze a pimple right, it can lead to scarring and further infection. But of course, we live in the real world where people squeeze their own pimples. We can't all just wait the 3-month waiting time to go to a dermatologist. Sometimes you just can't help yourself. So here's how to do it with the least amount of harm. So this is a harm minimization video for what to do if you must squeeze your pimples. Firstly, you want to make sure you're squeezing the right types of pimples. And what this means is waiting till the pimple comes to a head with visible pus. If there's no visible pus, you're squeezing, hoping that something will come out. There might not actually be anything in there to come out, and so you're just squeezing and causing extra damage for no reason. Secondly, this is pretty obvious, but you should do it hygienically. You are opening up a wound on your skin, and so you want it to be as clean as possible. What this means is clean skin and clean fingers. To clean your skin, you should wash it and then wipe it with alcohol. To clean your fingers, obviously you need to wash your hands. You can also wear gloves, and you can also cover your fingernails with a bit of tissue, and so that gives you a better grip as well. You can also use cotton buds instead to do the squeezing. The next thing you want is to lance your pimple before you squeeze it. And what this means is to stab it with a needle so that there's a passageway for the pus to come out. The needle should be sharp so that you make a hole as small as possible without causing extra damage from pressure. The needle should obviously also be clean, so you can use a brand new needle out of a sterile package. You can also sterilize a needle yourself, so for example, you can pass it through a flame and wipe it down with alcohol. So here's something that was new to me. You should lance your pimple at an angle. If you stab it straight down, what you might be doing is introducing pus at the surface deeper into the pimple. You want to lance it at an angle, or even better, horizontally, so that there's no chance of the pus going deeper into uninfected skin. When you're squeezing, you don't want to use too much pressure. If you use too much pressure, you're causing extra damage that's unnecessary. With squeezing your pimple, you should stop when clear liquid or blood comes out, when all the pus is out. Finally, once you've finished squeezing, wipe it off with either a clean piece of tissue or even an alcohol pad, and you can also cover it up with a bandage, for example a hydrocolloid bandage, to stop any extra infection going into your freshly clean pimple. So those are our tips on squeezing a pimple. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit like and subscribe to my channel. You can also follow me on Instagram and check out my blog for more beauty science. Let me know what you want me to talk about next time, and I will see you later. Don't squeeze too much.